Dear Topps Baseball Card Company, in 1960, I was an employee of a hotel in Miami Beach where Mickey Mantle was staying. I was summoned to Mr. Mantle's room to deliver room service to him. He ordered an egg salad sandwich. As I was setting up the room service tray, I noticed Mr. Mantle clipping his toenails. I'll never forget it as long as I live. I watched out of the corner of my eye as he clipped every toe. He had trouble with the last nail, but eventually his diligence paid off. At that moment, the telephone rang.
Hello?
Hi, Mickey. What are you doing?
Hey, baby. Leave the egg salad sandwich. I'll eat it later.
After Mr. Mantle left the room, I sat down and secured all the toenails that had been clipped off. There are almost 10 toenails, 9 and some shavings, but a full set. I want to donate this collection to your card company. Sincerely, Ted L. Nancy. Topps Baseball Card Company was so impressed with the idea of such a collection that they sent my letter onto the Hall of Fame. And can you believe it? The Hall of Fame wrote me back.
Dear Mr. Nancy, we're very interested in your story of the Mickey Mantle toenails and how you obtained them in Miami Beach in 1960 while delivering room service. This is a fascinating tale, and we'd be interested in examining them before we reach any decision. Thank you for thinking of the historical importance of these items. Sincerely, Peter Clark, Registrar.
I wonder what Mickey Mantle's nails could be worth. I'm going to ask my nephew Rudy to help me. He likes baseball and toenails. He wanted to get insurance for the nails in case something happened to them on the way to the Hall of Fame.
These are Mickey Mantle's toenails. And we need them insured because they're going to end up in the Hall of Fame with your help.
Paul, what do you think each toe is worth?
I don't know. I'm not an appraiser, but see how many we have. 2, 4, 6, 8. We have a full set.
It's a full set, plus shavings.
What is your uncle's name?
Ted L. Nancy, just like it sounds. He has a lime in his appendix.
25,000 contents, 100,000 liability.
Rudy's on his way to Cooperstown. He put up a few signs, just in case the nails get into the Hall of Fame. I wonder if they'll get in.
I have something that I hope, that you may find interesting.
Take a look at this letter. Remember that? If you like, you can read it out loud.
We are very interested in your story of the Mickey Mantle toenails and how you obtained them in Miami Beach in 1960 while delivering room service. Sincerely, Peter Clark.
That's you.
That's me.
Look at this, Mr. Clark.
My
gosh. Is that wonderful?
Look at that.
Each toenail's at a position.
Wow.
This nail's the pitcher. This is third base. That's the big
great toe.
On second base. Ready to turn a double play.
Well, I have some ideas. Where would you think they would go?
Well, we have, as you might know, Ty Cobb's dentures, which are on view up in the museum right now.
All right. Cobb Webb was one of my favorite ball players.
Cobb Webb was?
Yeah.
He's a great guy.
He's a great guy.
I was wondering if this can be enshrined here in the Baseball Hall of Fame.
This would just make our collection. This
really?
This could be the defining moment for the Hall of Fame right here.
This is a dream come true for myself, and I will speak for my uncle, Mr. Ted Nancy.
Great.
Thank you so much.
I wish I could meet him myself.